Welcome back to The Pulse. I'm Mark Barton. Israel has cut its growth forecast for this year. The finance ministry cut its targets to 3.2 from 4%. Israel's central bank had already reduced its growth forecast to 2.8 from 3.2%. They blame the European debt crisis. Exports account for 40% of Israel's GDP, and Europe is one of Israel's largest markets. The announcement sparked speculation the central bank would hold off cutting interest rates this month, strengthening the shekel. But our next guest thinks the move will be a short-term one. Rafael Gozlan is a chief economist at Israel Brokerage and Investment. He joins us now live from the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange. Rafael, good morning to you. Thank you very much for joining us today.
Thanks for inviting me.
I mean, the downgrade by the finance ministry to 3.2 from 4%, it's still quite bullish, isn't it? Because many of the investment community are looking for much weaker growth. What about yourselves?
Yeah, I think it's still quite bullish. I assume the growth in 2012 will reach only 2.7%. But I don't think that this is the point. I think the main point is the difference between the first half and the second half of the year. I think the Israeli economy actually now is in a slowing momentum. It reflects in the really slowing demand in the second half of 2011, and probably will continue in the first half of 2012. But I think that the Bank of Israel actually is reacting, and I think it will see this influence in the second half of the year. So maybe on average it will be something between 2.5% to 3%, but I think the focus should be on the second half, a better second half relative to the first half of the year.
And you're thinking that the Bank of Israel will cut rates, but only in the second quarter. Why not sooner?
No, I think it will end cutting rate in the second quarter. I believe that it will cut more in the one of the next couple of meetings. I'm not sure it will be on Monday, probably not, because we see better financial condition in Europe, and I think the Bank of Israel is well aware of it. But I think that if you read between the lines and the inflation numbers, you see actually a zero inflation environment in the second half of 2011. I think this is a thing that the bank will find it hard to ignore for a long period. So I'm not sure if it will be on next Monday, but probably if not in the months after.
We had the Israeli social protests last year, and that severely affected domestic demand. What's the outlook for consumer spending in the first and the second half?
Yeah, I think that the consumer will be more muted in the first half of the year, probably some of it due to the social protests, some of it due to a negative wealth effect, and also some we start to see some decline in housing prices. But I think you should be well aware that the unemployment rate is relatively low. I don't see much the unemployment going much higher. So I think you see the consumer back to business in the second half of the year. But I think that the Bank of Israel will support this issue. So I think that we'll see the bank cutting rates to about 2% till the second quarter of the year. And it will do it gradually. And reflection to the global developments.
Okay, Rafael, thanks very much for joining us today. Rafael Gozlan there, chief economist at Israel Brokerage and Investment.